In your courses, you're bound to run into many online discussion forums, as it's a great way to get students to interact with their peers. You can identify a discussion forum by its orange icon with a speech bubble inside. There are several different types of forums depending on how your professor sets it up. The most common is the standard forum. This forum allows students to create the discussion topics by clicking the Add Discussion Topic button. Then, other students can go in and reply. Just be sure to read your professor's instructions, as they may not want you to make your own discussion topics. They may just use this as a way to have multiple discussion topics of their own throughout the week. The second most common forum type is the Q&A format. In this type, students cannot create their own discussion topics. Instead, the professor will have created most likely multiple questions for you to go in and answer. It's important to note that in this format, you will not be able to see anyone else's posts until you submit your initial reply, which you can do so by simply clicking the reply button. After posting, you should be able to read others' responses and reply to them. Sometimes your professor may ask you to do more than a simple text post. They may ask you to link to a website or attach an image or some other file to your post. To do so, you will need to click the Advanced button underneath the text box. This will give you access to Moodle's full editor. To add an image, you can copy and paste an image, click and drag it in, or click the Image button and find the image on your computer. You can also use this last method to add any other file type. It doesn't have to be an image. Finally, let's talk about forum notification options. There are a few options for staying up to date on forum activity. First, we have the option to subscribe to the forum itself or individual topics within it. We can also check our notification preferences by clicking on our name in the top right, click on Preferences, then Notification Preferences. Scroll down to the Forum section. We can check or uncheck if we want notifications from any subscribed forum posts or forum digests on either Moodle itself or within our email. Finally, go back to the Preferences page and click on Forum Preferences. You can get pretty granular here, but I recommend just adding forum tracking, which will highlight new forum posts both on your course page and within the forum itself. And that's all the forum basics you need to know. Thank you for watching.